Hello, I'm Robert Christman, Marketing Manager and Voice of the Customer for Microtrends. In this video, we're going to review the latest batch of updates for the MD Cockpit application. MD Cockpit allows you to plan, monitor, adjust, analyze, and control your missions right from the tablet. Joining me today is Maud Morin, a product owner for our software development team. Welcome, Maud.
Thank you, Robert. I'm really pleased to be here today to present a new feature of the latest release of MD Cockpit.
Maud and her team have been hard at work on a number of new features that will enhance a user's experience with MD Cockpit. These new features include updates to the user interface, additions to drone configuration, enhancements to fail-safe warnings into the flight editor, new updates for our LiDAR products, and some additional features for terrain follow. Maud, I'll let you take it from here and demonstrate all the new features in this MD Cockpit 2021.1 update. Starting with the user interface, I understand there's a new button available showing the north orientation.
That's right, Robert. Let's have a look at it now. The new north arrow in the flight data view shows you the direction of north in relation to the map. So if we move, you can see here that the arrow also follows the orientation of the map. And when you tap the north arrow, the orientation of the map resets so that the north is at the top of the display. A filled north arrow means that the map has the default orientation.
Next is a very useful addition to the drone configuration menu, where the user can now access the cumulative flight time for their drone.
Thanks, Robert. You can find the new cumulative flight time in drone config. If you go in the main menu, drone config, you have access now to cumulative flight time. At the moment, it's not connected to a drone, so you can't see the number of hours, but it's the total flight time of your drone since its release. This information is necessary for micro drone preventive maintenance program.
Well, I can definitely say that's going to be a useful addition to MD Cockpit. So now let's go ahead and move on to the updates for our fail-safe warning notifications.
The first warning that has been renamed is the RC failsafe. It's now called C2 lost. The C2 lost is the loss of signal between the drone and the C2 device. C2 devices are MDRC and the tablet. That's why we renamed this warning in MD Cockpit. We have a second warning that has been revamped. It's the mandatory landing message when there's a critical battery level. In MD Cockpit, we show a warning when the drone has a critical battery level, but now we also show a warning for mandatory landing. The drone will automatically land because of the critical battery level.
Well, hopefully our users never put themselves in a situation to actually see those warnings, but they're there for backup just in case. So next, let's go ahead and move on to our several updates that we have with the flight editor.
So about the mission planning, we improve a different feature. The first one is improve curve flight in corridor. This feature includes two different functions. The first one is that the drone will automatically increase or decrease speed on curve turn, but it only applies with a minimum radius of 3 meters. So here we have a mission and we can see that we have a curve turn for corridor mapping. But if you change the radius here to less than 3 meters, then the drone won't be able to do the turn smoothly. So it's going to stop, turn, continue straight, stop, and change the heading and continue for the last leg. The second function that was changed is that corridor object now supports curve segment between 3 and 25 degrees. So let's have a look at it. If I pinpoint one of the waypoint here, you can see that if I move the waypoint, it's we can see the curve here. And if I go greater than 25 degrees, then it's not supported anymore. So you see the angle and here you see the curves. So that's the second feature that was added for the improved curve flight in corridor. So the second feature that was improved in the mission planning is the LiDAR SWAT and camera footprint visualization in curve turn. So let's have a look at it. If you go to corridor mapping in the parameters, you have access to the visibility icon. By clicking on the visibility icon here, the little eye, you enable the overlap. And now you can see, if we zoom in a little bit, that we support curves for the visualization of overlap. Here we have the mapper, so it's a little harder to see with a mapper as we take individual pictures. But if we change to another, the LiDAR products, we go to product line and we select MD LiDARs, then it's easier to visualize that the overlap also support curve turns. So the next feature for mission planning is the round trip corridor. It allows you to automatically double a leg of the flight path to bring your drone close to the start point. So if we have a look at it, now we have a corridor mapping survey here. And if we go to the object parameters, we have a new slider here down the menu that you can turn on. And then you see that if we turn it off again, so we have three legs, and when it's on, it adds one leg four, and it enables you to get the last leg closer to the starting point here. While we are here, I wanted also to show you that now the width is an independent parameter. So basically, if you change the width, it's not going to change the altitude or the overlap. So all parameters are now independent. So for example, if you have a width to be covered, you can set it in the mission planning to make sure that when you scan or when you acquire your data, everything is covered. So you can see that I changed it back to 80 meter and both parameters have stayed the same. So in the mission planning, we now have revamped the whole user interface of the mission item events. And it's easier to change the type of mapping object and the events that are associated with it. So here we have a complex survey that includes different kind of objects. So let's have a look at the waypoint first. If we go to waypoint, we select it, and then we go to the little pen. So now you can see that the user interface has changed, and you can go here and change directly. For example, if you want your first waypoint to be a takeoff waypoint, you can change it automatically. And also we have different events that are associated with your waypoint. So if you need to make, for example, a change of speed, or if you need to do any action related to the camera trigger, it's available to you now. Let's move on. It's also available for corridor survey. So you do the same kind of planning and you have access to different kind of event as well for the corridor, and similar for the survey polygons. So you can see here we have access to change speed or different action related to our camera. Last but not the least, we improved the bore site calibration by adding a field to set the length of your legs. So for example, if you need longer legs for your calibration, that's now available to you to get better results.
Well, great. I've always seen MD Cockpit as a very user-friendly and comprehensive planning software. So these additions are just going to make it that much better of an application to use for our users. So let's go ahead and move on to the MD LiDAR 3000. So it now has three payloads available, the V1, V2, and V3. And depending on which minivox is actually installed in your drone, MD Cockpit now has different ways to handle this.
So that's right, Robert. Here you can see if you go to the product line and you select your product, you now have three different versions available for the AMD LiDAR 3000. And the version depends on the version of Minibox that is installed on your drone. Also, when you land an old mission with AMD LiDAR 3000 waypoint file, it will automatically update to AMD LiDAR 3000 V1. We also updated the field of view to planning field of view. So the menu has been renamed. And for all the Minibox versions, we have now 56, 90, and 110 field of view available. And finally, for the AMD LiDAR 3000 V3, we give you the option to select the effective field of view, either less than or equal to 110 degrees or greater than 110 degrees.
Okay, great. Well, I'm definitely interested in these updates to the AMD LiDAR 3000. That 110 degree field of view, it's my understanding that's the maximum field of view that you can have between the skids underneath the drone. So that's a great improvement, I think. So this brings us to our final update for terrain follow. So let's go ahead and take a look at what's new there.
So about the terrain follow features, the drone is now more stable in turns when this feature is active. The results will be a higher data acquisition performance. We also updated the SRTM elevation data to the latest version. So you can see here, this is the default option now, but we still support SRTM 3 for older mission. And finally, if you go to the custom elevation source, we now support GeoTIFFs that have file extension with TIFF with 1F or TIFF with 2F. So the users don't have to go in the folder of AMD Cockpit and change the name, rename the file extension themselves.
Well, thank you very much for this demonstration. How can users access these latest updates and add them to AMD Cockpit?
The latest version of AMD Cockpit is available on the Google Play Store and on the service portal for our Chinese users.
Excellent. If you have any further questions, please contact your MicroDrones representative or sign into the MicroDrones client services.